हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट टुडे विद चैप्टर 11, लाइंस एंड एंगल्स। लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड फ्यू बेसिक ज्योमेट्रिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स। फर्स्ट इज अ पॉइंट, ए वेरी स्मॉल डॉट यूज टू फाइंड एन एग्जैक्ट लोकेशन। ए पॉइंट हैज़ नो लेंथ, ब्रेथ और थिकनेस। ऑल ऑफ यू नो दिस इज अ पॉइंट, ऑल राइट। सेकेंड इज लाइन, ए सेट ऑफ पॉइंट्स दैट एक्सटेंड्स इनडेफिनेटली इन ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शंस। इट हैज़ नो एंड पॉइंट्स। सो हियर ए बी इज अ लाइन। हियर यू कैन सी बोथ साइडेड एरोस। इट मीन्स इट इज एंडलेस इन बोथ डायरेक्शंस। थर्ड इज अ रे। इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ ए लाइन दैट हैज़ वन इनिशियल पॉइंट एंड एक्सटेंड्स इनडेफिनेटली इन वन डायरेक्शन। हियर इन ए रे वी कैन सी A is the initial point and it extends in one direction only. Okay. Next is a line segment. A line segment is a part of a line between two endpoints. It has a definite length. So when we have to draw a fixed length, that is a line segment. So AB is a line segment here. Next is a plane. A plane is a flat surface extends indefinitely in all directions. It has unlimited length and breadth, but it has no thickness. Here, this rectangular figure represents a plane. Now we can see here length and breadth of the plane, but there is no thickness. Here points A, B and C are lying in this plane. Next is collinear points. Three or more points lying in a plane are said to be collinear if they all lie on the same line. So here we can see points P, Q and R are lying on the same line. So these are collinear points. Next we have concurrent lines. Three or more lines in a plane are said to be concurrent if all of them pass through the same point. The point is called the point of concurrence. So here you can see line L, line M and line N all are passing through a fixed point A. So A is the point of concurrence and lines L, M and N are concurrent lines. Next we have to understand angles. A figure formed by two rays with a common initial point is called an angle. So here we are able to see an angle. Here angle PQR is an angle at Q. Q is a vertex at which angle is lying. So it will be written as angle PQR. Q is the vertex and this side PQ or QR, they are known as arms of the angle or sides of the angle. Next, interior and exterior of an angle. Here in this figure, we can see angle AOB at vertex O. Here in this inner part of the angle, points P and Q are lying on the boundary. Boundary means on the arms of the angle, we can see point U, point A and point B. But here point R, S and T are lying outside the angle. The points which are lying outside the angle are known as exterior points. Points P and Q which are lying inside the angle, they are known as interior points, and A, U and B are on the boundary here. So we can write here interior of angle AOB has points. Which points here we have? Points P and Q. So we will write here P and Q. And on boundary of the point, boundary we have points A, B and U. And exterior of angle AOB, here we have points R, S and T. Alright. Next we have different types of angles. You people have already discussed all types of angles in class 6. So let us recap of all these types of angles. First we have acute angles. Acute angles means angles less than 90 degree. Here less than 90 degree are known as acute angles. So here we can see angle AOB is an acute angle. Then we have obtuse angles. Obtuse angle means angles greater than 90 degree. So here we can see angle AOB, it is greater than 90 degree. So this is an obtuse angle. Next we have right angle. Right angle means equal to 90 degree. Alright. So here this angle AOB is a right angle. Then we have straight angle. Straight angle means angle of 180 degree. So a straight line, here we can see AB is a straight line and point O is the vertex at which this straight angle is lying. So this is of 180 degree straight angle. Then we have reflex angle. Reflex angle means the angle which is greater than 180 degree. So here we can see angle AOB. This is the reflex angle. Alright. Then we have last is complete angle. Complete angle means angle which is equal to 360 degree is known as complete angle. So when we have one complete turn. So this is a complete angle. Next we have now pair of angles. Pair of angle means two angles in different ways we have to discuss. First is adjacent angles. What are adjacent angles? If two angles have one common arm, a common vertex, and other two arms are on opposite side of the common arm, then the angles are adjacent angles. Here, this figure represents two adjacent angles. First is angle AOB, because angles are lying on vertex O. So first angle is angle AOB and second angle is angle BOC. Alright, and here OB is the common arm, O is the common vertex, and the other two arms OC and OA are lying on the opposite side of OB. Alright, so we can see here that angle AOB and angle BOC are adjacent angles. Okay, so common vertex is angle O, common vertex is point O, OB is the common arm, and OA and OC are on the opposite side of OB. Alright. Linear pair. If two adjacent angles have sum of angles 180 degree, then they form a linear pair. Now we know when we have the sum of two angles 180 degree, it means they must be lying on a straight line. Here two angles AOP and POB all together, they are making an angle of 180 degree. So we will say that these two angles are in linear pair. So we can write them as angle AOP plus angle POB is equal to 180 degree. Okay. So in total, they are equal to angle AOB, that is a straight angle. Okay, so in linear pair here, which two angles we have? One is angle AOP and angle POB are in linear pair. Next we have complementary angles. Complementary angles, if two angles have their sum equal to 90 degree, they are known as complementary angles. One is called the complement of the other. Here in this figure, you can see angle ABD. Angle ABD is 30 degree. Angle DBC, it is of 60 degree. But when we put both these angles together, In total, they are making a right angle. Right angle means 90 degree. So here angle ABD 30 degree, this is angle ABD 30 degree. Angle DBC 60 degree, here this is angle DBC 60 degree. In total, they become equal to angle ABC, which is a right angle. So we can say that these two angles are complementary angles. Angle ABD, here I can write angle ABD and angle DBC are complementary angles. So one is known as complement of the other. Okay, so it means we can see that 30 degree is complement of 60 degree and 60 degree is complement of 30 degree. So when we have to find the complement of any angle, how do we find? So we can write here complement of 30 degree. How we will find it? We will subtract it from 90, because sum of two angles 90 makes complementary angles. So when we know one angle, other angle will be 90 minus that angle. So we get 60 degree as complement of 30 degree. All right. Next, we have supplementary angles. Same way here, supplementary angles. If two angles have their sum equal to 180 degree, they are known as supplementary angles. One is called supplement of the other. In complementary angles, we have done sum of angles 90 degree. So remember, supplementary angles will have sum of angles 180 degree. Here, angle PQR is 60 degree and angle RQS is 120 degree. Alright, so when we put both these angles together, PQR and RQS, 60 plus 120 makes 180 degree. So we can say here 60 degree, supplement of 60 degree is 120 degree and supplementary of 120 degree is 60 degree. So here we can write angle PQR and angle RQS are supplementary angles. Okay. And if we want to find supplement of 60 degree, what we will do? We will subtract it from 180 degree. 180 minus 60, that is equal to 120 degree. So supplement of 60 comes as 120 degree. Next, we have vertically opposite angles. So when two straight angles intersect each other, pair of angles so formed without common arm. Without common arm means on opposite side of the vertex are known as vertically opposite angles. Here you can see line PQ and line RS, they are intersecting at one point. Now this is the vertex at which they are intersecting. I can name it as vertex O. We have the property that vertically opposite angles are equal. So here we can see angle 1 is vertically opposite to angle 3 and angle 2 is vertically opposite to angle 4, as they are lying on the opposite side of the vertex to each other. Angle, so I will write angle 1 is equal to angle 3, because vertically opposite angles are equal, and angle 2 and 4 are vertically opposite to each other, so they are equal. Angle 2 is vertically opposite to angle 4 and they are equal. So we can write why they are equal, because they are vertically opposite angles. Next, we have angles on a straight line. As we have already discussed, a straight angle. Straight angle means where we have 180 degree. Here, when we have more than two angles, so two or more angles with a common vertex form a straight line, then the sum of angles is 180 degree. So here you can see on this straight line AE, we can see four angles. 50 degree, 60 degree, 30 degree and 40 degree. Now they are on the same vertex O and on the same straight line AE. So sum of all here is 180 degree. So we can say here that 50 plus 60 plus 30 plus 40. If you will add them, you will get their sum 180 degree. So, all these are angles on a straight line. These are angles on a straight line. Alright. Next, we have angles formed at a point. Now, here in this figure, you can see point O around which we have four angles. Alright, so if more than two angles formed at a point make a complete turn, you can see here around this point O we have a complete turn. The sum of angles is 360 degree. So let us check this also. Let us try the sum of all these angles. 110 plus 90 plus 70 plus 90. So we get here 360 degree. So it means here all these angles formed around a point, they have their sum equal to. Let us start with exercise 11.1. First question is, find complementary and supplementary angles. So first part is 26 degree, for which we have to find the complement as well as supplement. Complement of any angle we know how to find. Complement of any angle we find by subtracting that angle from 90 degree. So we will write here complement of 26 degree is 90 minus 26. That is equal to 64 degree. Alright. And same way supplement of 26 will be 180 minus 26. Okay, so it will be equal to 154 degree. Alright, second question is, you are given a figure in which angle POR is given. POR we can see here in the figure is angle 1. We are given only angle 1, 53 degree, and we have to find angle 2, 3 and 4. So I will write here angle POR is equal to angle 1 is equal to 53 degree. Now we have done about vertically opposite angles. Okay, vertically opposite angle means angle on the opposite side of the vertex to it. So here 3 is vertically opposite to it and we know vertically opposite angles are equal. So 1 will be equal to angle 3. So therefore why it is equal? I will write the reason here, vertically opposite angles. Alright, so it means angle 3 is also equal to 53 degree. Alright, then angle 1 and 2, they are in linear pair. Linear pair means two angles on a straight line which have sum equal to 180 degree. Okay, so we can write 1 and 2 in linear pair or 3 and 4 also in linear pair. So let us find angle 2 by 1 plus 2 is equal to 180 degree. Why the sum of them is 180? Because this is a linear pair. Alright. So 1 we know is equal to 53 degree. So 53 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degree. So angle 2 becomes 180 minus 53. 180 minus 53 means it is 127 degree. Now, if angle 2 is 127, if angle 2 is 127, angle 4 is vertically opposite to it. Alright, so we can write here angle 2 is equal to angle 4 because this is also vertically opposite angle. So if angle 2 is 127, it means angle 4 is also equal to 127. Alright, so now we got answer as angle 2 is equal to 127 degree, angle 3 is equal to 53 degree, and angle 4 is also equal to 127 degree. Alright, then comes your third question. Third question, we are given the figure in which we have to find x. Now we can see here a straight line upon which a pair of angles we are given. It means that is a linear pair, x and 80 degrees. So how will you find x? It means we know in a linear pair sum of angles is 180 degree. Alright, so we will write here x plus 80 is equal to 180 degree. Why? Because this is a linear pair. So when we will take 80 to other side, it will be 180 minus 80. So x is equal to 100 degree. So keep in mind the number of angles we have on a straight line. Some of them will be equal to 180 degree. So this way we can find the missing angle. Alright. So we will do till question 3 today. So you will complete the remaining parts of question 1 and question 3.